Well, Elizabeth Warren released her Medicare for All financing plan, and political commentators are weighing in. I also released a video about it, but our friend Ben Shapiro also decided to give his take on it. And what I love about this clip that I'm going to show you is he's going to react to something that he clearly knows nothing about, and he's going to talk about numbers as if he's never seen them before, because healthcare spending in the US, it's astronomical, right, compared to other countries. But the way that he talks about this, it's as if he's never actually looked up how much we're already spending on healthcare. So it's evident he doesn't know much about US healthcare policy. In spite of that, he's still going to pontificate about a subject that he knows nothing about and proceed to make a complete and utter fool of himself. And I'll admit, this was thoroughly enjoyable.
Again, her Medicare for All plan is just a perfect window into the bizarre mind of Elizabeth Warren. According to Reason.com, Reason Magazine, her plan to finance Medicare for All at a total price tag of nearly $52 trillion, including about $20 trillion of new government spending, an estimate that is probably low. She keeps saying that she's not going to increase middle-class taxes, but that's obviously false. For example, the chief trick that she plays when she proposes Medicare for All is that she says that the employee-based insurance program, so your employer pays in and then you pay in. Your employer pays in maybe 8%, you pay in maybe 7%, and that pays for your health care. She's just going to take all of that and turn that into a tax that goes to the federal government. That's called a tax. Now, people may say, well, it doesn't come out of my bottom line. Well, it does, because, see, here's the thing. Your employer-based health care insurance is actually good. Medicare, not nearly as good. So she's just converting private expenditures into a tax and then not calling it a tax. And she refers to it as an employer Medicare contribution. Oh, it's voluntary now. Sure, that is in fact a tax, obviously.
That was basically his head when he saw that $52 trillion cost. But, you know, something that he is conveniently leaving out is that the cost with Medicare for All at $52 trillion, that takes into account total healthcare spending, which includes federal, state, individual, private. But what he doesn't tell you is that actually not doing Medicare for All would cost more. It would cost more money. So Medicare for All is actually cheaper in terms of reducing total healthcare spending. But before I say that, I'll also just add that I also have my issues with the way that Elizabeth Warren funds Medicare for All. I prefer a payroll tax as opposed to her regressive head tax. With that being said, though, to say that $52 trillion is a type of shocking statistic, or he didn't say it, but I mean, it was evident in, you know, with the tone in his voice that this was somehow shocking, it goes to show you that he doesn't know what he's talking about. So I'm going to be extra kind to Ben Shapiro here, and I'm going to argue with statistics that he can't possibly disagree with. We're going to cite a conservative Koch-funded Mercatus Center study to demonstrate how much we really are paying for healthcare in this country. So I want to show you this graph from the brilliant Andrea Witty of connectthedotsusa.com, who shows you just how much we are projected to spend over the next 10 years. This is according to an estimate by the Mercatus Center. That is $59.7 trillion overall. If you look at the total on that left bar, it's almost $60 trillion. So this estimate that Elizabeth Warren came up with is actually low. But to the right of that, you can see that moving to Medicare for All single payer will actually reduce overall spending by about $2 trillion. So when we saw all of these headlines about how a Koch-funded study found that Medicare for All actually saves $2 trillion overall, this is what we're looking at. Overall health spending will be reduced. Now, there's a number of reasons why this will be the case, but a huge share of savings comes from the elimination of administrative costs. But, you know, that's kind of besides the point. What I want you to look at is federal spending, which is the yellow portion of these bars. So the federal government is already projected to spend trillions of dollars over the next 10 years on healthcare. So regardless if we do Medicare for All or not, we will be spending trillions of dollars on healthcare. Now, if we pass Medicare for All, what actually changes is the amount of federal spending versus state, private, and individual spending. So while federal spending increases, state and local and individual and private spending decreases under a Medicare for All system, while overall total healthcare savings also comes down. Now, you can argue about how long it will take for some of these savings to take effect. There's debate about that, and that's reasonable. But what isn't reasonable is for people like Ben Shapiro to not explain that $52 trillion is less in total healthcare spending than if we actually keep the status quo. So I'm going to make a prediction. Over the next week or so, since Elizabeth Warren did cite $52.5 trillion as total healthcare spending, a lot of mainstream news outlets will basically cite that as the cost for Medicare for All without telling you that not doing Medicare for All would cost more if we're looking at total healthcare spending. Because again, even if we increase federal spending, overall healthcare costs come down. Because that administrative savings, it really is important. Because if you are a hospital and you only have to bill one entity, the federal government, that's a lot easier, right? You don't have to have legal departments and individuals that you hire just to do paperwork to file, you know, these different claims and whatnot for private insurance. You don't have to do any of that with single payer. So you save a lot of money alone just by doing Medicare for All and doing away with those administrative costs. So you're going to hear people say $52.5 trillion, but please acknowledge that what that refers to is total healthcare spending over the next 10 years, and that is less with Medicare for All than if we maintained the status quo. Now, getting back to Ben Shapiro's argument here, he also left us with another gem. Your employer-based healthcare insurance is actually good. Medicare, not nearly as good.
You're wrong.
I mean, how out of touch do you have to be to make a statement like that? You may get good health insurance through your employer, but the problem with that is when you link your health insurance to your employer, your ability to maintain said health insurance will be contingent on your employment with that company. So that's an inherently unstable system, and it could leave people vulnerable if they have a job change. And you could lose your insurance on a whim if your employer decides that they want to go with a different provider. So this takes the healthcare choices out of your hands, because you are restricted to what your employer wants. You're restricted to the network that they want you to have. So it's not better. And when it comes to Medicare, it's largely cited as the most popular social program for a reason. But here's the thing. What Ben Shapiro isn't telling you is that before we expand Medicare to everyone, we are first going to improve it. I mean, there's a reason why the slogan that you'll see on the posters in Medicare for All protests is love it, improve it, Medicare for All. Because before we expand that, we have to improve it. Because there's a lot of loopholes that exist in current Medicare, which require people to get supplemental coverage through private insurers that gouge them. So what we're trying to do is close all of those loopholes and expand coverage. So that way, when we actually do roll out Medicare for All and expand it to everyone, it will be comprehensive. It will actually be sustainable. But Ben Shapiro, of course, I don't even know what type of healthcare reform he's in favor of. He'd probably say, well, we just need, you know, more of the private market and less government, which is incredibly stupid. And I don't want to straw man him, but I'm assuming if he is a conservative, that's what he'd opt for, right? A more neoliberal approach to healthcare reform, because that is something that conservatives and corporate Democrats have in agreement. But the problem with a private insurance-based healthcare system is you are incentivizing people being ripped off, right? If you don't take that profit motive out of the equation, if you don't decommodify healthcare, then you're not prioritizing the delivery of healthcare. You're prioritizing profits, which is why we are in the current predicament where we're at right now, where millions of people are uninsured and millions more are underinsured. They have insurance, but they don't realize that it's actually shitty insurance. And unfortunately, under the Affordable Care Act, premiums are continuing to increase because it actually isn't too affordable after all. What is affordable is pretty subjective. So what matters is making sure that every single person, regardless of their income, has access to real healthcare, and not just access to insurance, access to healthcare, meaning it's free at the point of service, and if they want to see a doctor, they just call their doctor, make an appointment, and show them their Medicare card. That's it. But Ben Shapiro, what he argues for is always going to be what's best for the private sector, what's best for multinational corporations, right? So it doesn't even matter. Even if objectively speaking, a policy like Medicare for All is better, to him, big government is inherently bad. So even if we shouldn't theoretically, from a moral standpoint even, have a healthcare system that depends on the private sector, it doesn't matter what actually delivers the best public policy, because he takes a default position of government bad, but unfortunately for him, that just automatically means that if you don't want government, big government will then be replaced by big business. So pick your poison. It's one or the other. I'd rather opt for big government, because at least we can elect who's in control of our government to a degree, right? We may have an oligarchy. We may have special interests drowning out our voices in elections. But I don't get to elect who's on the board of Aetna or on the board of Blue Cross Blue Shield. But Ben Shapiro, he's a hack. So in the event the Republican Party came out in favor of Medicare for All, he would suddenly change his tune, because that's what he does. He's playing on a team, Team Republican, Team Conservatives, and he's going to rep their position no matter what and no matter what it is.
Alpha male, not a beta male.